welcome back to the Fan Hub with Shelter 2.
Michelle Gadoni
and Tiffany Makena.
Today we'll be discussing about gaseous exchange in fish, frog, and insects. It will be a continuation of the gaseous exchange.
Okay, so under the insects, we have the tracheal system, which consists of the spiracles and the tracheals. The spiracles are external openings present on either side of the abdomen and the thorax. And their function is to allow air to enter from the atmosphere. Then after that, the spiracles then open into larger tracheals, tubes, which are called the trachea. And the function of the trachea is also to allow the air to pass. After these tubes, the spiracles then open into larger tracheal tubes called the trachea. And these tubes are reinforced with spiral bands of the chitin to keep them open. The trachea then subdivide into finer tubes called the tracheals, and the function of the tracheals is to allow gaseous exchange. Tracheals lack the spiral bands of chitin and permit the exchange across their thin moist walls. I'll then leave it to Tetu to explain the gaseous exchange in a fish.
Okay, gaseous exchange in fish. As we all know, fish live in water, and they also need gaseous exchange. So their fish use, they have some parts that they use for breathing. We have the mouth, also known as the buccal cavity. We have the gills, we have the operculum cavity. We also have the positioning of the fish, a bony fish. A fish has three parts, that is the gill recurves, gill filaments, and the gill bar. I'm going to draw the structure and show you the functions of those parts. So these are the gill recurves. This is the gill bar. And these are the gill filaments. All these three parts, they have their functions. First, I'll start with the gill filaments. The gill filaments, they increase surface area for gaseous exchange in a fish. And the gill recurves, their work is used to trap any food substances and any bad substances that are not supposed to enter the gill filaments. And then we have the gill bar. The gill bar, its function is to hold the gill filaments and the gill recurves. It provides support for the both gill recurves and the gill filaments. So I leave it to my colleague Tiffany to take it from there.
We have the mechanism of gaseous exchange in amphibians. Respiratory structures of the amphibians. We have the skin, the lungs, and the mouth cavity. We'll talk about the skin. In the skin, we have, in amphibians, like for example, a frog, they have a thin skin which is moisturized, which also has a large network of blood capillaries. Beneath the skin, that's where we have the large network of blood capillaries. Oxygen from the air can be diffused through the skin onto the blood capillaries for gaseous exchange to be able to take place in our. We have come to the end of our discussion today on Science Hub. I have been Tiffany McKenna.
Michelle Gadoni.
Michelle Tito.
Keep it Elimu TV, where we watch and learn.